welcome to God's View. I'm your host, Pastor Gracie, and the purpose of this program is to bring you ordinary people living extraordinary lives through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The title of the program today is Mission Impossible to Mission Accomplished, and that is awesome today that it fit in because my guest today is Mary Ann Fitchum, and she had exactly just that. A mission impossible situation, and I'll let her herself, let her give the viewers her testimony, which is absolutely phenomenal. Good morning, Marianne. How are you?
I'm very good. Very good.
Thank you. Praise God. Yes, you are. Yes. And I'm so wonderful. It's so wonderful to have you on the show. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you.
And I'd
thank
like you to, oh, you're, yeah. you know, anything that glorifies God and has a wonderful testimony with a genuine about them, which you do. People need to see that.
Right.
And people
Absolutely.
Need to be encouraged. They
There's
need to
somebody
know.
Somebody out there that needs to hear
Amen.
Us.
There are somebody out there, many people or whatever, one, two, it doesn't matter, but they need to hear your testimony.
Absolutely.
So please, go ahead and give your
well,
testimony.
I'd like to start with your title. Your title is awesome because I'm right in the middle of that, okay? What happened to me was, you know, back early in 2006, I was having kidney issues, ended up in the hospital. I was given a call about my blood. I was malnutrition, I was told.
Wow.
I thought, well, you know what, I was six, I didn't eat. Explains it. Had taken the kids to Disney over the summer. Thought I was, you know, healed with the Cipro that they had given me and the medication and the hospital, the IV and all of that.
Went through a lot even with that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And went to Disney, and it was my son's birthday gift. And we had a wonderful time, but the pain was back, and I was sick again. And I wasn't going to disappoint my children, so I forged on.
Just like a mother.
Exactly. And what happened was I came back to New York. I knew I needed to get a doctor. Didn't have a regular general practitioner or anything like that. I'm not a doctor person.
And That's
I,
okay.
So I did. I found one, went to her, told her my kidney hurts. And that I had a kidney infection, came pre-diagnosed as well.
And, which we often do to ourselves.
And I, and she, you know, sent me for a regular physical because she wanted to get an idea of who I am and
exactly,
what I was about.
Which was
and,
the right
okay,
thing to do because
exactly.
you haven't been at a doctor's exactly. in a while.
Absolutely.
And once they get you,
yeah, I know.
That's
they
it.
Suck
but,
you right in.
But that's okay. Go ahead.
Okay. So I had gone, did exactly what she told me to do. When the blood test come back, she said that she was very concerned about it. And she wanted me to go see an oncologist. I agreed. I didn't have a problem with that. So I went to, and he set up all these tests and everything, and I did the blood tests and everything. And,
in the meantime, I'm just curious, in the meantime in your mind now, when she mentioned the word oncologist, what were you thinking?
I didn't even think.
Wow.
And you know, when I sat there, after getting my diagnosis, I looked at his title and I was like, oh.
That's who
so
you are.
What was I thinking?
Isn't
I don't
that
know.
Something?
I wasn't thinking. But
well,
you know, and just so you know,
that.
Just so you know, both my parents are deceased from cancer. They did the whole chemotherapy, radiation, the whole nine yards. So
wow.
I was very, you know, tainted as far as chemotherapy and the treatments
that.
They have for cancer.
I can